alaikum. Here we'll see how to use a Postman and this Google API, which is geocode, where we send latitude and longitude to verify your correctness, whether you are getting the data from Google server or not. We'll see that. Here I have this URL, which is this one. Now, this is the URL which points to this endpoint, and using this endpoint, we can interact with Google Map and get data from the server, from Google server, for Google Map server, okay? Now, at the same time, you need to pass this two parameters over here. The first one is stands for latitude. The second one is stands for longitude. So we need to send this two using this comma, okay? And we are going to create a get method or get request. So if you hit the send button, of course, you will see error over here. Now, that's because here it says that you must use API key. Now, of course, if you've seen my previous tutorial, you should know that how to register an account to Google Map and get the API key. Now, here we are not sending it, so that's why we get this error. So now here I'll put the key over here. So I would do key equal. So this is the key that I have. And over here, now we are sending the get request one more time and waiting for this authentication and status code 200, okay? So yes, if your API key is correct, in general, you get status code 200, okay? And here is your information. Now you can take this information on your backend and decode it and use whichever you need. Okay, now, of course, this is directly talking to the Google Map from Postman, but in general, this is not what you want. Of course, you can use it for debugging purpose. In general, you'd use in your backend where you will have RESTful API. So here I have this. So here I'm, this is my endpoint for my RESTful API. So it talks to the server and hit this endpoint. At the same time, I'm sending this latitude and longitude, which is exactly the same one. Of course, it has a lot more digits, much longer, but here I have trimmed it. I don't need that long, but it doesn't matter. But here, you don't need to send, in general, your API key, because your API key should be saved in the server, in your server, okay? Not sent through URL or your RESTful API, okay? Now, if you hit it, so here we'll see that it's getting me the same result. Like here I have this one, okay? So here I also have this one, okay? So they're getting me the same result. Yeah, and they might vary a little bit, but they are almost the same, okay? Yeah. Because of this one. Because now here, of course, I can go ahead and change this one, okay? And let me see over here, we'll do the same. Okay, now they will have exact result. Okay, because they're hitting the same, this latitude and longitude. Okay, as you can see. All right, they're same. So the point is you have to send latitude, longitude, and your API key. Now over here, this is coming from my server, and my server endpoint is this one. So in general, in your server endpoint, okay, this is my server endpoint, this one. So I'm sending latitude and longitude. And over here, this is the URL that you saw early, which is this one. Okay, so in general, this kind of URL you would use internally in your code, in your endpoint. And then here you have to put your API key, okay? So if you put that, in general, you should get response back, which should be status code 200, okay? All right, so that's how you work with your Google Map and Google Map API and Postman. Thank you.